Father, we just lift them up too in a special way. Just fill that void as long as you can. Father, if these are gathered here, may we worship you. Spirit in the truth this morning, and even to Father. Thank you for our pastor, Lord. Just pray a special anointing on him this morning as he breaks the bread and life to us. Now we ask that you a special blessing upon this altar. May we receive, give, and glory. God, may be used up in the like him. Jesus, only name I pray. Amen. May stand at will and sing What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Thank you. heaven. They was people re-educating their life. You don't understand what we was in here. God, y'all were here struggling, studying spiritual warfare. Well, I tell you, we stand around on the mountaintop, getting to shout down for the glory of God. I just sat in a service like that, and a long time after the service was over, God just came and sat down among us. He spoke through the mouth of faith, and they preached, and they shouted out the word of God. And if people came to repentance and came to know of God, just keep them lifted up. Keep them in your prayers. Keep these families lifted. We ride that mountaintop because that, the people that are in that valley right now, that's the same God. They ain't no different God that's over us. The people on the mountaintop that are in the valley, you lift you back up on that mountaintop. Church, I know you're hurting this morning, but God's got something in store for this church. Let me tell you.
Hello, Randall. Good, you.
Morning, name it. I do. Any more.
Fix his phone. No.
I heard a preacher say one. See, a whole lot of preaching. Losing the back. I can honestly say. As we're but there is nothing that changes. That for just a moment. All that he'll have to do change. Things are written as the Word of God said, heaven and earth have not believe. This morning, it's going to be a change for the scripture. It's our head. Victory. It might be ups, downs. There might be far in a row. quit crying out and why dost thou show grievance? And there, for the wicked, therefore wrong to into the heart. Hear how long that it long is losing. Watch when you see this. The thing of prophets and other prophets through a man. And most times, the nation of Israel would pronounce judgment. Yes, the children of Israel, because of your sinfulness, and it was also. And you won't because of that. But instead of to the people, God being a message to. Only Habakkuk is quote on any other verse. Probably not because, but because, let's face it. In the old. Most of the three we find Jesus for the old. But he think it's we have paragraphs one who's strong. Here's the idea. When you read these, first, the prophet. What he heard. with what I might be mad because into eternity, I just wanted to make sure about that. It's about down, and there was the same. The devotions. God has, and you do not will. Have you ever prayed? I know right now is the situation by the moving situation instead of better. Seemingly, no hope. But it seems like head popped up on I can tell you this. Guaranteed somebody don't care about what I'm doing. How are you not going to do it? See my answer. I didn't have to reverse the number. Yesterday, are you kidding? I said that. lack of sense. Oh Lord, my and then we at a point in time. But at the end, if you are in your life, it will not just wrapped up in that. There's so much wrapped. That tells me that this morning I was at my phone that we didn't hear enough today, so they're in the class or hear me, but I probably can't. That we can't hear. See, amen. The body language. Amen. I bet it's a different language. But I understood what. And so I said, amen. But we are here. We're trying to figure out exactly. And so, you know, hey, well, this morning I didn't want to be. Memorial service to figure out what time table. We all believe. I see. The thing is, I got your present. And I don't want to. Do you? Had this trouble. And we're raising because his soul. Listen, I have said this morning that faith is trust. trust. And you trust. This morning, we got to hear. Got in that little blue room. And before I hope you're sorry. I said, well, it's as I was thinking about that this morning, when we come in, our attitude has to be move in a mighty way. We should trust and speak to our situation or through the lesson in the disciple life. Trust that dependable and trust. It's trusting Him for salvation. Not for by grace. You're saved through faith. Not works that earn it, that is trust for us. Can I use a shield? I have been learning about taking up the shield. Wherewith you shall be able to quit with the devil. That means when I can hope and know that it's gonna be okay. They hurt. They may be broken. But if I hold tight, it won't help me. Faith is salvation. Faith is my shield. But can I say it's also my stance? Something to stand on. Into the back to fight gonna turn me. I come in the name of the Lord God. You have to fight. Promises that will not fail. Hanging on the promise, we will prevail. Too many of us and citizens are going to sell the prayer. Listen. In Job chapter 13. Psalm 2, verse 12. Blessed are put their trust. The Lord is my fortress, my deliverer, my God, whom I will. My butler and the horn of my salvation, my high. 37 verse 40, the Lord had delivered them from the weak. Psalm 56, verse 3. What time I will end. Church, it's time to put the church where in Him. When we were in the house after our son. Who you tell? Was willing to pray for us to talk to us. Came back to Thursday night. The young man of our church. There was a time in his church David had just saved that church and never got over. Listen, in this he had suffered some tragedy. And connected to this. And when he said, grant us the strength. Grant us the faith that we're going to say, oh, all this breaks out. They're going to be missed, but it's not. It's our season. If I want to say anymore, I'll see you later. Hey, by the way, things are going. It's going. I'll be home in just a moment. I need to see you in just a little bit. Not the Baptist Church, the trust that we will trust in the same God. That will lead on the same that these individuals lead on. Being devastated and defeated, we can live in our soul and the hell back. Genesis in chapter 3, verse 4. Back at the prophet, won't she be enough? Because verse number 2 says, O Lord, I was afraid, O Lord, provide thy. they go and get right at the middle of us. So, here's something that we have to understand. Is nobody knows what she does. As a matter of fact, it's been transliterated from the Hebrew to the English. It's been brought over to us because they don't understand what it means. They know it's a musical term. They don't know if it's the cadence, the measure. They don't know if in my Bible it says probably musical instruments. Even O.C.I. Schofield didn't have what she and all means figured out. But, in my reading, studying, and listening, it has been proposed, which I'm going to hold on to. If you don't want to, that's your choice. But it has been proposed that she and all can mean ignorance turned into victory. Ignorance turned into victory. Because in chapter 1, he said, God, don't understand. Why? And in chapter 3, he sang a song. Chapter 3, he's praying a prayer. John, I don't know how long it took, but can you imagine the transformation? God, why? And he's over here saying, I've heard you. In these days that we are in, remember mercy. In these days that we are in, revive your works in us. In these days that we're... And he begins to pray. Now, in his belief, listen to me. Are y'all still with me? I'm fixing the land of plunder. Are you with me? So he's brought these musical instruments, and instead of just going through this prayer of our Father who art in heaven, he's singing a song prayer. He's singing a hymn. And can I just direct your attention to verse number 17? Because at the end of this, he says, although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruit be in the vines, the labor of the olive shall fail, the field shall yield no meat, the flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. What's he saying? Even if what I see doesn't change, verse 18 says this, I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. What's he saying? Even if I still don't know why, I got a song. Even if I still don't get it figured out, I got something to sing about. Because listen, is that not what rejoicing is? I don't know if I'm helping you this morning, but I walked in here broke, and the Holy Ghost was helping me this morning, and I hope He is you. Even if I can't get it all figured out, I still can sing. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus and to take Him at His word. Even when I feel like I'm alone, I can still sing, what a friend we have in Jesus. Even when I feel like I got nowhere to go, I can still sing at the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. And we can still rejoice. And that's what Habakkuk said. Even when I don't care. If there's no blooms, if there's no fruit, if there's no flocks in the field, I can still rejoice. What's he saying? I'm sitting here looking around, and the landscape still looks bleak. I'm still looking around, and there's still brokenness. There's still battles. There's still burdens. And I don't know why, but he's going to bring you to reality. The Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter 8, I am persuaded. You and I think persuaded to be one thing. Let me tell you what Paul said. I'm convinced of something you can't unconvince me of. I believe in something you can't change my belief in. I believe in something. I'm persuaded about something. I'm convinced about something. You can't change my mind about it. It doesn't matter what comes. It doesn't matter what happens. It doesn't matter what's said. It doesn't matter what's coming around me. You can't change. It doesn't matter what I see. It doesn't matter what I hear. It doesn't matter what I feel. I am convinced, persuaded, that absolutely nothing can separate us from the love of God. Neither height, nor depth, nor breadth. There's not trials, there's not tribulation, there's not sickness, there's not sorrow. There's nothing in this world or the next world. There's nothing happening now, nothing going to happen in the future that can separate us. No, he said, nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. That's what the Bible is saying right here. Even though what I've seen it change, even though how I feel it change, yet I will sing and rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. Why? Listen to this. He's my strength. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. We love that verse. But in its context, Paul said, if I'm really hungry, I can be hungry in the strength of Christ Jesus. If I'm to have food in my belly, I can have food in my belly and enjoy it through the strength in which God gives me. If I'm to have or to be without, whatever state I'm in, I can be content. Right? What's he talking about? If I'm in need, if I'm in want, if I'm sick, if I'm hurt, if I'm broke, if I'm burdened, if I'm in a battle, I can trust that Christ will give me strength to bear the burden, to win the battle, to deal with the brokenness. I can trust in the strength God gives me. Habakkuk is saying here, I can sing and I can rejoice because he's my strength. Not only is he my strength, but he allows me to say it. Notice what he says. He will make my feet like hinds' feet. He's referring to what we call in America the ibex, which is in this portion of Israel. It's a deer-like animal. And they will scurry up rock ledges, and there'll be little edges of rock sticking out that are very little, but they don't fall. Because their feet remain from that kind of terrain. We have been learning through the book of Ephesians that our feet ought to be shod in the preparation of the gospel of peace. What does that mean? If I take Ephesians 6 and I take Habakkuk chapter 3, then God has given me shoes to live in a terrain in which he has placed me. Is that not logical to draw that? And so I don't have to worry about whether or not I'm going to sleep. Because if I'm standing on the solid rock of Jesus Christ, it ain't no slippery way. I don't have to worry about slipping and falling because he's not a slippery slope. He is a solid rock. I can plant both feet on him and I can stand against the current. The Bible says I'm going to rejoice and I'm going to have joy because the Lord's my strength. He is my ability to stand. And thirdly, he said that he will make me walk upon high places. He is going to be the summit. The psalmist said this, Lord, take me to a place that's higher than I. I've been in some places. Let me tell you something. Just this past week, just this very week, I got to a place I ain't been to in a long time. Y'all listen to what I'm saying. Pay attention up here a minute. He was able to move me to a place. He was able to put me in a place where I can't tell you even now who's to the right of me and who's to the left of me. I can't tell you who's in front of me. I don't know who's behind me. But I can tell you who was all around me, and that was the Holy Spirit. In my brokenness and in my burdenness, he was able to lift me up, and he was able to take me a place above it all. And for just a little while, I got some relief because all the time that mattered was he's on the throne. The only thing that mattered was he was in control. The only thing that mattered strength. He's the one who replaced the stone. He's the one who said that I can stand through in the blood of all. This thing I don't need to complain. I have no idea what is on your heart. I know we're all strength. Listen. And there may be more than just myself in here this morning, Lord, and say, how do I? Or you may be looking around and you may say, this is how you go fix it? This is what you're doing? Trust me. Trust me. This past week, I can still see her little tearful eyes. Lotta was willing to do something. She couldn't. And there was reasons behind it. That 7-year-old Jan Ann. And I looked at her and I said, you're going to have to trust your daddy. And just accept the answer. There are things that you don't understand. And that's why my answer is not. Well, I hate it when he turns my own words against me. But how true is it? When sometimes his answer is, you just need to trust me. Trust me. And then, we triumph. Singing that. One of the songs we sung is, there is not going to be a lot for us. I'm going to give it to the Lord. That was the message. Satan wants you to sit down, shut up, focus on brokenness, focus on the battle, focus on the burden. The Bible says, even if I don't sleep working out, I'm on a choice. Stay on your feet. As she plays his bad and nice clothes, you're here today, and maybe you just want to come on the bow and say, Lord, I don't understand you. I don't trust you. Lord, I don't trust you. Lord, it makes no sense, but I will trust you. Lord, I ain't got to figure out, but I'm just going to trust you. Lord, at the end of the day, here's the only thing I know to do. The only thing I know to do is just leave it in your hands, and then I'm going to raise my hands in prayer. I'm going to put this at your feet, and I'm going to raise my hands up high. I'm going to say, Lord, here am I. I just want to praise you. Just going to clap my hands. Just a little. Thank you. would please hit stop on my phone.
Hey, Green, I stopped you.